Hello everyone, welcome to Sunburned Albino Plays Spyro 3 Year of the Dragon Episode 1. We're here, we've done it. We beat the first game, we beat the second game, now we're gonna start beating the third game. You can see I've already got 117% profile here. Let's select a new icon. Who do I like? There's not a lot of choices. I guess we'll do Sparks. They wouldn't even give me Spyro as a choice because I've already used him. Alrighty then. You know, you would think they'd give me like Sheila and people like that, but I guess we're not introduced to them yet. Until the start of the story and whatnot. But that's alright. Go ahead and watch as all of our eggs get taken again. You know, I totally forgot that she existed. Bianca, right? That was her name? I think she's actually kind of likable. At least I like her a lot more than the sorceress, right? Sorceress is just like an ugly, fat Rhinoch lady. But Bianca's got some things going on. Hunter, you slow. A powerful villain emerges.
We managed to capture the eggs, Your Highness. Every last one.
Excellent. Maybe you will amount to something after all. Now, go guard the tunnels. Stop anyone from coming through.
Both bad guys are female. This is SJW bullshit. And in 2001 of all years... Please. Is this 2001? It might be 2000, like, 2 or 3. That's probably 1, because this is, yeah, PS1 era. 2002 was the PS2, I think. Maybe 3.
We found some of the eggs, but they were too heavy to carry back.
The other side of the world?
The forgotten...
I don't know video game history, so don't quote me on it.
Spyro. You'll have to go. Nobody else can fit down the holes.
Yeah, come on, let's go!
Find the eggs and bring them back, Spyro. You're our only chance.
You got it!
That dragon changes colors every game, but it's always the same one. All right, we can begin this. I'm excited, you know? I can't give, like, full, like, feedback on what I think of the game because I don't remember a lot of it. Also, what I need to do real quick is turn the volume down, probably. Sound. Yeah, that should be good. I don't need to save right now, but thanks. Oh yeah, Triangle is back. I'm not playing Kingdom Hearts here. Okay, let's see if there's anything different about the controls. It doesn't seem like it. It seems like they took the Spyro 2 mechanics and ran with them for this one as well, which is a smart decision, because those were great. I'm not sure what they could have improved. Yeah, we seem to jump maybe slightly higher, but no, I think it's about the same. Just testing just how exact can we be with charge jumps and things of that nature. Alright, this is a pond, and therefore it is not anything. I like how there's more collectibles. You know, like, there's more eggs than there were orbs. There's what, like 101 eggs? Or something of that nature? Meanwhile, there were like 64 orbs, I think? And you know, they're just kind of hanging out, they're easy to see. And while maybe it is slightly annoying that they have, like, a find animation, you know. But you can skip it with Start, you don't have to watch the babies, you know, come out hatching, trying to do tricks or whatever. Also, the main villain just kind of hangs out and talks to us for some reason.
So, you're the one in charge of rescuing the eggs, huh? How sad. Look here, dragon. If you know what's good for you, you'll turn around and crawl back up that hole you came through. Those eggs belong to us now, and I've hidden them in places you'll never find in 1,000 years. Besides, even if you could find an egg, our expertly trained armies will dispose of you and take it back. Do I make myself clear? If I find you here again, I am going to be very angry. And you won't like me when I'm angry.
Angry? Well, don't be angry, Bianca. Please, we didn't do anything yet. We will never find an egg in 1,000 years. Remember with this one, they just sat it right out in the open, didn't they? Hey, there's an egg right there, too. To look left or right, press the yep. Oh, to quickly center the camera behind you, press the L1 or R1 button. Oh, that's okay. Gotcha. So it's not L2 and R2 at the same time anymore. Which is kind of weird, actually. Not sure why they needed to do that. But, you know, it's whatever. Okay, we don't... I kind of like that, like, we can get everything right off the bat. You know, because we're not going to gain any new power-ups as this goes. Instead, we get Sparks power-ups that are just sort of quality of life improvements. They're not necessary to progress, which is positive in my opinion. I don't like having to go back and revisit worlds. I want to get it all in one shot, you know? So we are going to go to Sunny Villa. Just a nice, basic sort of beginning area. It's gonna be nice. Okay.
Oh my, can you help us? Hordes of ferocious rhinox have overrun our town and kidnapped the mayor.
Kidnapped the mayor? Overrun our town? Oh, do not worry, I will get you back. I will save everybody. There's no need to be whatever you would... I don't know. I don't know anymore. Okay. There is... You know, some of the change... They've made the NPC characters a little more important. Which, you know, it tries to... Because, you know, like, you didn't really care in Spyro 2 about anybody you talked to in the world. You didn't care about the Glimmer Mice. You didn't care about the Robot Farm robots. Because they didn't really do anything outside of just stay where they were and hand you a talisman after you made it through their level, regardless of whether or not you actually did what they told you to do. You know, like, the Glimmer Mouse was like, hey, you know, please clear out these lizards so we can mine again, but if you just go to the end of the level without even killing a single enemy, they'll still give you the talisman.
Let me catch my breath and I'll kick that other guy's butt.
I'll kick it for you with my horns. My feet horns. Hey, I did it for you.
We showed those two bullies. If they hadn't outnumbered me 2-1, I'd have finished them off ages ago.
Well, I suppose that the Roman Colosseum atmosphere was filled with a lot of posturing. Dude's got no sense of... self, really. Humility, you know? Recognizing one's own faults. Get out of my face. Highly train my ass, Bianca. You know, Bianca evokes some sympathy, right? Like, even in the game, and she becomes, like, what, a love interest for Hunter? I think that's a smart decision. I'd rather she was one for me. Because I live vicariously through Spyro, I guess. I did. I am not Spyro, I just control Spyro, right? But I say me, but I mean, like, I don't mean me. I don't want Bianca to, like, come through the TV and, like, unzip her hoodie or whatever. Her shaman robe. I mean, I don't not want that either, now that we're talking about it, but... It's, you know... I'm just looking out for my boy Spyro here. He gets a lot of no chicks at all. He doesn't get any chicks. There's no female Spyro counterpart, at least not in the first three games. I don't know if Skylanders, he's got some bitches. But, yeah.
I'm trying to remember Enter the Dragonfly, because that's the latest Spyro game I ever played. And who were the characters in that game? I only remember Spyro in that game. I don't remember him talking to a single other person. We just traversed through an empty world, devoid of human contact, or dragon contact for that matter. And it was just an exercise in loneliness. Made me real depressed when I played it. I never finished that game. I don't even know what I'm talking about. You should be able to glean that from the ramblings that are taking place right now. But those are probably why you watch this series, because I don't really do it in any other of my videos. Only Spyro. You know, I'm here for like the nostalgia binge. I bring it to YouTube, and it doesn't matter. This series doesn't matter. You know what I mean? But I still do it, because I like doing it. We need Sheila to be... Aw, dicks. There is, like... We're gonna have to come back here. But we didn't have a choice. I don't know, there's probably a... Like, if there's a world that doesn't have Sheila in it, we could have just done that world and then come here to get the treasure that we needed to free her.
That means your progress is saved.
Well, thanks, Zoe. What happens if I light you on fire? Does that mean your progress is ended forever? I'm getting the biggest deja vu right now. I feel like I've done this episode before, like a long time ago. I feel like I played Spyro Year of the Dragon, even though I know I didn't. And I feel like after I was standing in front of those big dudes, I looked at the chicken legs in their arms and I was like, that's making me so hungry right now. And so then I just had that thought again just now. And it was like, whoa, alternate universe, the multiverse is overlapping. I just experienced a world in which I have already done this series for YouTube before. This pool is for no reason.
Thanks for the help, but I think I would have worn him down in a minute.
No, you would not have worn him down at all. He would have smashed you to a pulp with food.
But thanks. Oh yeah, Spyro 3 introduces the skateboard. I think Tony Hawk was a big deal at around this point in time. So they were like, we want Tony Hawk and Spyro.
Thank you for rescuing my town. As mayor, I award you with one of our famous giant chicken eggs.
Don't you think, as mayor, you should be visually distinguishable from your subjects? Oh, Sanders is gonna grow up to be a comedian.
I'm sorry. That was the ugliest chicken I've ever seen.
How dare you say that to me? Yep, just, you know, leave your people ungoverned for the foreseeable future. Nah, it's cool. The economy's gonna fall apart, and there will be revolts and peasant burnings of pitchforks. They're gonna light the pitchforks on fire and burn the crops. I mean, that's just what humanity is, you know? As soon as there's
Hi, Spyro,
not somebody in charge, we go
ballistic.
I found
this gladiator training arena, and it makes a pretty cool skate park. Care for a test of your boarding skills?
Yeah. I bet you can't catch all 15 of the lizards running around here. Just come back if you want some boarding tips from the master.
I remember spending like 45 minutes on this shit. Because it's so hard to do. Like, I think we're not allowed to wipe out, although maybe that's the second time. Yeah, get out of my face. Yep, there it is. No, okay, we can wipe out this time. The skateboard controls are adequate, but at the same, sometimes you can, get fucked a little bit. If you're trying to make a turn in the wrong place, I really wish they did not put treasure in this place, because I am so distracted trying to get it all. We gotta do it, you know? We're gonna 117% this game. Which, I'm not really sure how that number was created, you know? Oh, nice jump. No, really good. Fantastic. There needs to be, like, a hairpin turn. Like, I need to be able to drift or, like, break or something. Honestly, that's all this needs to be, like, so much more fun than it is. Instead, I just look like garbage accidentally going up pipes that I don't want to go up. You know? This is like if Tony Hawk had a pet dragon. But the dragon was like, I can fly. Why do you want me to get on this board? And then Tony Hawk's like, you have to be what I say you want to be. The people expect the dragon to skateboard. They expect anything that has to do with me to skateboard. You better do it. You're not going to get any dinner anymore. I will stop feeding you human babies. And I was just like, all right, chill, man. Just like hook me to the board so I don't fall off, right? Like, no, just use your wings to reduce drag or, I don't know, friction. By the way, what happened to this dude? I could have sworn there was a dude that I missed, and I was trying to get him again. And he just decided to up and disappear. Why would you put gems on this? Oh my god. I'm actually so disappointed in the lack of a sharp turn option here. Maybe skateboards don't work like that. What do I know? And maybe, I mean, like you would think, but it's really just kind of because the fact that all four of our paws are on the board, right? You know, if an actual skateboarder wants to... Oh, just let me up there. Wants to do a quick turn, they'll use their foot. They'll take one of their feet off the board and just turn with it. Our legs kind of aren't shaped like that. So, I mean, I'm not going to sit here and say that I don't understand why this is not allowed. But I will say I am disappointed. And why do you put gems right here? I jump up here and immediately wipe out. What do you expect from me at that point? Are you kidding me? There's one I missed? I wiped it on purpose because I want this one. Alright, apparently we gotta get back up here. I don't mind the skateboarding sections. It's just... I like them a lot less than I thought I did just now. Like, as I'm now doing it. But it's still, you know... How the fuck do we get up here? Oh, there's a ramp. Well, you could have told me that. I don't know why none of you are real-timing me this. Alright, yeah, just wipe out. I don't care. I'm here for the treasure. You've gone and made me do it. You've made me collect treasure. And without the option to, A, break. Like, why can't I... If you're not gonna give me the turn, at least let me just, like, slow down. Skateboarders are not bound to the speed at which they start. I know I'm giving you guys a lot of grief. I'm talking directly to Insomniac now because I have a direct line of communication with him. This fucking lizard, dude. I know I'm giving you a lot of grief about your skateboarding controls, but... Like, can you patch this game, please? Could you do it? I am this fucking lizard. Oh my... If they do a Spyro remaster, they should address this. I don't need you to keep but we need to keep the experience pristine. No. You add skateboard mechanics that make it less shitty. And we will love you forever.
All
right. If you can catch all the lizards without wiping out and before time runs out, I might be able to scrounge up another egg. It's not gonna be easy, though.
How about I do none of that and you give me the egg, as this is our mission, and the dragons will not be happy with you holding out on us. You think? You think? I think. Alright, great. 1 of 15. I don't expect to screw this up, but you never know. It's mostly just these half-pipe stuff I get a little iffy on, especially if I go up a half-pipe by accident when I was just trying to, like, get around it. Could happen. And these guys just, like, run up the ramp like there's some kind of escape helicopter waiting outside. Okay, land correctly. Thank you. We are dicks. Where'd it go? They just run around. Camera doesn't let me get a good look. Oh, I got him. Okay. Yeah, you press X to go up the half pipe. And then if you don't press X, it'll just go up the ramp. And, like, go up the other side. So we should be good. 10 of 15, not terrible. I'm gonna have to get the ones down this way. Oh boy. Oh!
Oh.
Dod. Fuck it. Hunter, I will skin you. Boy. I used to think you could land backwards, but you totally can't. Okay, now we're good. I missed a gem? You can't be doing this to me. My heart is not what it used to be. It can't handle the stress. God damn it. Oh, nope. Okay. Oh, yeah, just don't even go up the ramp. That was actually probably positive, but doesn't mean I like it. There you are, you son of a bitch. You don't have to press X here. It's not like it's gonna ram you into the wall if you don't do the actual jump. There's still a balloon man here. Oh my gosh. I don't have the time for this. But, you know. Yeah, we're good. Then we'll just circle back around, get this dude, and get the gem that he... Where is it? Get up the ramp. Ah! What does it take? There's a gem. Thanks for that. Alright, we're missing a fiver somewhere, I imagine. Although it probably has nothing to do with this now that I think about it. 12 of 15. We've got one right there. It's probably it this way. This is probably how we get it. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, see? Yeah. But now you got a question. Oh, over here. Cool. That's basic, you know? I guess we'll do this ramp so we can actually, like, get going in the right direction. Yes. Gotcha.
Whoa, that...
Look, there was another egg in the lizard burrow. Hey, it's Daisy. Well, that's one of the dumb ones. Might as well put it back in the pile. Why does it say I have 50... Don't you have to, like, hold triangle? You have to hold something to do, like, actual tricks. Oh, it is triangle, I think. And then you can just do tricks, right? But they have to be, like, off jumps, I believe. damn. There's a trick called the Nasty Nork, which I think is very nice. Nah, but I'm out. I'm out, son. See ya. It was a grand old time, but actually, I didn't think so. And yeah, we will not get all the treasure in this level because there is a Sheila mission that we cannot do. But did I do everything else? Let's go into Atlas. It'll tell me. Sunny Villa, 4 of 6 eggs. Both of them will be in Sheila's mission. Sounds good. Alright, let's get the hell out of Dodge. You know, successful first episode. It's not quite over. I'll scrounge around for some eggs in the hub world. One thing I can't say about Spyro 3 is that it has a lot less stuff that I inherently don't look forward to, which is great. All right, there's the 400 that is necessary to buy you out.
Spyro! My, my, how funny to see you here.
Well, I haven't seen you since we defeated Ripto. Getting paid a fortune to keep Sheila locked up? Well, let's... Oh, it only takes 300. How nice.
I hope you appreciate this favor I'm doing in letting you out.
As good of you, mate. No hard feelings, eh?
Right. After all, I'm just doing my job.
I reckon you'd be one of them dragons, then.
Yeah, named Spyro.
Never thought I'd see one. You dragons used to rule this entire world, you know. Then all of a sudden you left. Whew.
Dragons used to live here?
Didn't you know? They say it was over 1,000 years ago, I think.
And they just left?
Yeah, and the weird thing is, after they left, all the magic in the world just sort of went with them. I mean, they say this world used to have magic coming out the wazoo. Flying ships, singing forests, wishing stones, you name it. But when the dragons left, it all just dried up.
Is that why some of the portals don't work?
Yeah, they're starting to fade out too, one by one. Well, I gotta get back home and do some damage control. Come visit anytime you like.
Alright, but not right now, you see. I got other business to attend to. Don't know why I spent 300 gems bailing out a total stranger, but hopefully you won't let me down. Are we gonna become fast friends in our fight against the sorceress? Do we have a common enemy in that way? I suppose we do. I suppose we do. Hey, what's up?
Yo, Spyro!
Oh, are you gonna teach me how to glide? Damn. Glad. Thank you for that. I didn't know. It's been 3 games, but, you know, my basic-ass small, tiny dragon skills are getting hella rusty.
Did you just come back? Don't act like I failed. I went somewhere I didn't even care about, alright?
I saw something shiny in that cave over...
Alright. What makes you think dragon eggs are shiny? Oh, you think they glisten because they're all speckled? A speckled egg like Easter? Hey,
oh,
you know, Easter
I
is coming
forgot.
Up. This is thematically
I found this egg.
Dated well. You almost forgot you found this. This is the shiny thing. Oh. Oh, Hunter. Name a dragon Coltrane. You don't know. You don't know modern pop culture, dragons. What makes you think? Anything.
This is a super fly power-up, Spyro.
Oh, really? Does it let me fly superly? Well, then that's awesome, isn't it? It is exactly what it sounds like. On-the-nose naming of things is always helpful when it comes to figuring out what they do. Ain't that something? It is for me. I very much appreciate it. This entire video is just me saying bullshit. Just, oh, and it's non-stop. That's why I love it. Now don't get on the whirlwind. It comes a lot more naturally at nighttime. I should record more videos at night. When my brain is like, you know what, just settle for dumb shit. That's all you gotta say. I don't know what gender you are, but I feel like you're gonna spend most of your life trying to figure that out. Alright, there's more gems down here. They still make a lovely sound. I do enjoy it. The hub world's much bigger now. And it has challenges of its own. It does feel more streamlined that way. Can I help you, Hunter?
I see an egg at the bottom.
I would go get it, but I don't want to get my fur all wet. Oh, yeah, you know. We've enlisted you to help return babies that have yet to hatch. We're talking about human lives, dragon lives, whatever. I view myself as whatever I say. But no, if you will get your fur wet, then we just have a giant issue. Liam?
I don't know who you are. I don't know what you want. But I have a very particular set of wings. They do not work. They can barely keep me afloat for like half a second. I will not be able to find you. Because I'm just a baby. I don't even know English. This is all my thought process. It's kind of like Family Guy. People can understand me, but can they really? It's a question.
I guess Family Guy answered that question in one of the episodes. They're like, oh, what do you think, Stewie, who I can understand? And then they just solved the mystery forever. There was so much speculation. They really do get it. Can we breathe underwater? Can dragons breathe underwater, or are we just holding our breath? It's like, I'm pressing circle right now, so like I'm blowing bubbles because I'm underwater, because obviously flame powers wouldn't work in water. But like, that's me exhaling, so it's not like I'm holding my breath and then I can just exhale it forever. You know, we must be able to breathe underwater. Or does sparks give us the power?
Spyro, I got a special task for Sparks. Meet me back here later.
Why don't you meet me back here now? This is something I'd love to do before we actually leave the place. I want my Sparks power. We need 14 eggs to power up the portals. There's a lot of magic in dragon babies. That's probably why the sorceress took them. She wants to harness the power for her own gain. And then Bianca's just some dumb bitch she hired. I don't know. Unless she... Didn't she say she was like the sorceress's niece or something? I mean, who were the sorceress's parents? Because whatever animal made Bianca is like a fine piece of ass. But is like a sister... Like, the mother of Bianca is the sister to the sorceress, but the sorceress is like this disgusting, craven wretch person. So you gotta wonder, like, where does the species intermingling-ness leave the creation of them, you know? Or is she just one giant recessive gene in an otherwise disgusting family? I guess we gotta go to Cloud Spire Caves, or whatever it's called. Or we do Sheila's World. Anyway, that's gonna do it for this episode, so I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, you can like, share, and subscribe, and whatnot. You know, stick around, watch me play Spyro 3. It's gonna be a grand old time, I assure you. It'll be a lot like this, so don't expect anything better or worse. And I'll see you guys next time.